We're on. Go ahead.
Okay.
We may be interrupt. I have another appointment, but I don't know if he's going to make it today. It's iffy, so we may be interrupted.
Okay.
It would be on my cell phone, so we can use that time.
So say what you said. You're knocking on my door this time, but just do what you did before.
Say hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi, Mr. Waters. Mr. Waters, you got a problem, sir. Claude Diamond here.
What's that? Who are you?
Claude Diamond, sir. You got a big problem. You're going to lose this house July 18th, and that's unnecessary. Would you like a couple ideas how to possibly save the house or be able to derive some of your capital from it before you lose it?
Look, man, I've had a ton of you guys come by. I'm not interested in doing anything. Yeah, please just leave us alone.
Okay. I respect that. But let me ask you something before I go. You really want to lose? You have about $18,000, $19,000 worth of equity in this home. Don't you want to save that? Or if there was a way to save it, wouldn't it be worth talking to me for 2-3 minutes?
Well, how are you? Yeah, but how are you different from all those other guys?
That's a great question. Thank you for asking. I appreciate your directness, sir, by the way. It's really refreshing. I wish more people were like that. My name's Claude Diamond. I basically consult with people on how to save their home or save their equity in the home. I am an investor too. And what I do is offer alternative suggestions that may be a benefit to you. Could we sit down for a couple minutes? Would you and your wife like to go out to dinner with me or sit down for a few minutes on the lawn here? And I might have, if I can ask you a few questions, I may be able to help you. No guarantees.
Well, you're not gonna charge me anything, are you?
Suppose I waived my fee. How would you feel about that?
Yeah, I guess we could take a couple minutes.
Thank you.
Okay, great.
Suppose I waive my fee. I like that.
Yeah.
Well, normally I charge a lot of money, but since you're 6 months behind in your payments, I didn't think you'd have any anyway.
Right.
On there. The one is another thing from today that was really good. If somebody comes to you today, you go outside, you go to Vaughn's. They're having a special on Arrogant Bastard beer. You go to Vaughn's. Somebody comes up to you. This nice girl comes up to you. Dirk Waters, how are you? I haven't seen you since Washington. My God, look at you. You look fantastic. And you don't know who this girl is. You're totally lost. And she knows you. She's acknowledging you. She's chatting away with you and everything. What are you going to do?
Play dumb. Not play dumb. Play along.
Play along. Exactly. Aren't you going to say to her, I'm sorry, I don't know who the fuck you are. I don't remember you. Are you going to say that?
No, because you don't know how you know them either.
Yeah. Truth be told, this happens to me all the time. And I go to Claudia, who was that? And she'll say, oh, that was the chief of police wife. We had dinner with them about a couple months ago. You remember? We sat down with 3 hours with them. And I'm going, oh, God. You know, why do we fake it till you make it? Why do we fake it, nod our heads, and go along until we either hopefully remember or we get out of that conversation without embarrassing ourselves? Why do we do that? We don't want...
You don't want to look bad.
Yeah. So how do we utilize that concept? We don't want to look bad. We don't want to be embarrassed. Even though maybe this person, who knows, you know, in sales, how could we utilize that the same way?
Flip the script on the prospect.
Do you ever go to a party, cocktail party, people have name badges?
Mm-hmm.
You want to have some fun? Dirk Waters, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great, man. Wait, how long you been here?
About 45 minutes.
Oh, geez. I can't even remember the last time I saw you. What's going on? You still driving that car?
No, I actually just got a new Benz last year.
Good for you, man. Good, good. How's that pretty girlfriend of yours? Or did you get married?
No, we got married.
Oh, okay. See, it's so easy.
Mm-hmm.
You're going, who is this guy?
Because I don't want to say it.
Who is this?
I don't want to. Yeah.
Who is this?
I don't want to say, who are you?
Who the fuck are you? I don't know who you are. Some people might do that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I've been known to sometimes You know, just I got that from my mom. She was very outspoken, very straightforward. I don't know who the hell you are. You know, my mom would say that. But think about the advantage of you could go up to anybody and engage them in a conversation. You know, and just and they're there. They can't leave. They're stuck because right. They don't want to embarrass themselves.
Yeah, that's really good.
Yeah, and can we? You know, in sales, millennials have a big problem because they're so used to texting and emailing and stuff that they don't know how to do this engagement on a personal level, much less do cold calling or door knocking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know how hard that is.
I've been doing it.
It's hard. I have a lot of respect for you for doing it. If you can do that, Dirk, you can do anything, man.
I got a good lead 10 minutes before we hopped on this call.
Yeah.
I mean, right now we're getting our systems in place and we're getting internet leads and everything like that. But this is a way to get leads now.
How do you engage that person? You got the lead. They contacted you, Dirk. I lost you.
Yeah.
Okay, you're back.
Okay.
How did you get the lead? Are we frozen? Oh, darn. Are we back?
Yeah, I can see you.
Okay. How did you get the lead?
Today?
Yeah.
Yeah, I knocked on the door.
Oh, okay. And you're going to follow up?
Yeah, I'm going to follow up and I'll get this appointment.
Okay. Beautiful. It's hard.
Mm-hmm.
You can do that. If you can cold call, you can do anything.
You know, I think it's like when you start to work out, it kind of sucks.
It hurts.
But, you know, I've been doing it for – it does. But I've been doing it for 10 years, and, you know, I'm probably in the 95th percentile of strength, and now it's fun to do a lot of weight.
You like it.
You know, you get good. It's fun.
Isn't it good when something is fun? I like to run every day. People can't believe – most people hate exercise. I love going out in the morning. It's cold. I go on these single-track things. I see the wildlife. I'm by myself. I can pee anywhere I want. And I'm just – you know when you get that after about 3-4 miles and you get that light sweat on your body and you start feeling good and everything? Mm-hmm. And I love that stuff.
Yeah.
And most people you talk to, tomorrow, or I don't exercise or whatever.
Yeah, I'm not a runner yet.
You know, you don't have to be. There's plenty of other exercises. But you have to find something that you're passionate about so you can do it consistently and there's enjoyment in it. And that includes sales.
Well, I think you can, with things you don't necessarily like door knocking, force a bunch of reps, and then it'll get easier and easier, and you'll get better at it.
Why do you think I say 5 calls a day?
Consistency.
Yeah. Plus, if I can get somebody to make 5 calls a day, that's 25 to 35 calls a week. I'm going to look like a genius, because if they talk to 35 people, one person is going to say yes and buy their damn widget.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's too brutal to their ego, the rejection and everything else, then they're going to clean the toilet before they pick up the phone or knock on a door.
Right.
But if I can't even get them to engage every day with 5 people consistently, I do it every day. I talk to people all day long, and I monetize it.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I've got to do. Now, I got to have some skill sets and some knowledge, okay? But if I can put it all together, I can't help but succeed.
Right. Yeah.
And that's the key.
Cool. Can you send me that? I'm gonna. Can I post that?